Welcome back to the workshop. I have literally just got a couple of things finished. We got paint on the gear and it's all stickered up, everything else. Basic light kit in it, although I need to do a few wire extensions, and the lightweight's been finished off as well. I actually managed to shoot video on this. As you can see, he's had an upgrade in the wheel and tire department as well. But the main reason for today is new toy and another unboxing. I'm going to stay there. No, I don't think I'm going to be that lucky today. So, I am doing, with a couple of buddies of mine, a 48-hour weekend build-off. And my weapon of choice for this was Tamiya's new 1991 Audi V8 Touring. So it's based on the TTO2 chassis. I think it's a doable project. The goal is to, in theory, it's supposed to be a sealed pack tomorrow morning and doing donuts around the lounge on Sunday evening. But rather than film tomorrow, basically, when I think I'm going to be a little bit short of time, I figured we'd just have a quick squint through the box, mainly at the body, because I think if you want to know what TTO2 chassis looks like, you can just Google that and find out. So I'll bring the camera in a bit over the shoulder and we'll rip into what we've got. So, yeah, it looks like you can see that all right. Good. So, nothing exciting. Stuff on the box, whatever. So, box art special for this. Hoping I can get it done with one can of Tamiya paint. We've got PS1 there, so just pure white. I've got a Savox 15 kilogram servo to go in the front. I've got to be honest, it's going to be more of a shelf queen than it is a driver. But it just looks fantastic. Receiver. And then we're into the nitty gritty that comes with a kit. So it comes with Tamiya's own speed controller, which again for a shelf queen is going to be fine. With a 1.5 amp BEC, it's a little bit underrated for your servo. And we've got, by the looks of things, the classic, everything in plastic bag set from Tamiya, which is nice. In fact, it's actually, I've got to be honest, I'm leaving it with the bushes and bushes in it rather than bearings again. But the thing we most want to see is the dark gold BBS alloys. I hope they come out okay. You can see them. I'm sure the boys aren't going to mind. If I just rip the bag open. So these are quite nice, really. So, inserts to go in the standard externals. 12mm hex on the back, by the looks of things. But the main reason for buying this is the body. And it's another beauty, actually. I mean, as much as I wasn't proposing to do lots of Tamiya builds, I have to say, this one's pretty good. The best part, they've done the hard job. They've gone around the arches, and I'm not sure whether they look like they might be stamped out rather than cut out. But all said and done, they've done the difficult bit. And it's a three-part mould, so there's a mould line that runs across top half of the bonnet, and there's another one that runs up through the rear quarter window and just over the top of the body, but it's not too bad. Again, I would have preferred it if it had not had the body post holes in it, just because of, you know, I want it as a shelf queen, but given that most people will be using it and running it around tracks, can't really argue with that. The light bucket set is vac formed again, holes for your LEDs. Markings for your LEDs anyway. I think I'm going to need to grab some silver paint to paint those up a bit. We'll have to check what the sticker set's like. And it looks like there's dimples in there so you can drill out and then shoe glue your LEDs in of choice. Now, a rough look, it looks like we've got 5mm for our main headlamps and 3mm on the inside. Again, position for 5s and 3mm on the rear tail lamps there. This over there for the moment. Tyres, nice soft slick, so they may need a coat of insulating tape if I'm going to be donutting downstairs on the lounge floor. And then these are just Tamiya's wheels, good size, nice and easy. You can just bolt the inserts in. Self-tapping screws, I would imagine, on the back there. And they'll look pretty funky, I would think. I've looked at a variety of pictures. Sometimes the gold, because they're BBS wheels, sometimes the gold looks a little lighter than this plastic. Sometimes it looks darker. 6 of 1/2 dozen of the other, I think. You know, have to choose on that. Oh, and then the rest of it's just mountains of... Oh, okay. TTO2 style tub. Plastic. Drive shafty stuff. Drive cups. And really, the bit that's probably going to be most difficult. So, set of body destructions. Classic chassis. And flipping it, two sticker sheets. Holy smokes. For the gear, I have to say, the Carmen gear was not a quick job with the stickers with all the window surrounds. And I look like I've lined myself up for something very similar for this thing then. So, yeah. That to me does not look like a 45 minute job. Now the saving grace is the headlamps appear to have got the markings on, but over a transparent, so I can just paint the back silver and they should look pretty groovy. Everything else looks reasonable. Plenty of gentle curves to cut, so I guess these go all the way around the window surrounds, etc. Marked door handles and what have you. And then this is the... Oh, and then these are the perimeters to go around the bottom of the body on the air dam and everything else then. I think the hairdryer and the pair of scissors are going to get a good workout this weekend. So, as it's 48 hours, my plan is tomorrow morning, crack on with the body. So, cut it out, trim it, Scotch-Brite the inside, wash it. Can I see paint masks in here? Yep. Paint mask, and then just build up probably 3, 4, maybe even 5 thin coats of white paint during the day. Whilst that's being painted, I can crack on with the chassis, because my gut feeling is I'm going to need most of Sunday to do stickers. And the plan is to, I've got some LEDs in the cupboard, so the plan is to do a lighting kit, do a plug and everything else, as I've got a 6-channel receiver. Of course, I'm only going to use 2 channels, so I'll end up with a spare fitting on that, so that will give me at least enough power to do the lamps. Part of me, I mean, I've been watching K-pop RC. He did a lovely job on one of his Nissan GTR builds, I think it was, where he ended up with a separate standalone like 9-volt battery and a small switch so that you can display the model on a shelf or something like that and turn the lights on. I think I might be rude and nick that idea a bit later on down the line, but certainly for the moment, for the weekend, get cracking. This is where we're at. So the two chaps I'm also building with, Tim. Tim's chosen a Nova Fox, so I'll flash a picture up here, and Adam is cheating by using a pre-painted Tamiya pumpkin. So I think Adam can be done in about 3 hours, and I think Tim and I are going to be sweating it and taking the mickey out of each other on WhatsApp for most of the weekend. Right, what I will try and do is shoot some videos through the weekend. Whether I get them edited and up in time or not, I have no idea. We'll figure it out. If I do, I'll pop them up. If not, there'll be follow-ons next week. Okay, cool. Right, I better pack everything back up and pretend that it's a still sealed in box, as it were, for tomorrow morning. And we'll get cracking. Okay, see you. Hopefully, see you at some point tomorrow. Cheers.